incompletion. You felt that pain. Am I right? We are going to complete that source today. Pain you went through without naming, before even you know language, before you know to name it. Getting it? So, even to make the first statement about you, in that disempowering cognition, you need to cognize that you are powerless. You have a survival threat. So there is something which the force which creates the powerless moment. We are going to complete with that force which creates powerlessness in us. Powerless moments in us. How many of you are cognizing? Can anyone of you come and tell me your mamakara, ahankara? Please come to the mic. First statement you made about you.
Yes, my mamakara was that I am loser.
So, you made that statement when you are completely powerless. But before making that statement, you felt the powerlessness. Am I right?
Right.
That needs to be completed. Not only the word you created, the mood which created that word in you. Now all of you are cognizing? Completing, see, not only completing with the seed, completing even with the ground which may allow the seed to sprout. So that the, even if some other seed is put in that ground, it will not sprout. See, it's like if a seed should not sprout, traditionally, they will just roast the seed. Have you seen? They'll just roast the seed at vessel and roast the that groundnut and all they roast. They roast the seed. Roasting the seed is only the completion process you did till yesterday. Now we go one step further. Boil the land itself. Get the sand and boil it to such extent it is completely baked. How the brick is baked. Bake the sand so that even if some other seed is dropped into that, it can never grow. This process only will avoid rebirth. Please understand. If you just bake the seed, okay, that seed will not sprout. But the possibility for some other seed is there. Better bake the land itself, ground itself. Means the original powerlessness you feel in your life. Completing with that. Any of you have done this primal scream therapy? In the West it is very popular. Primal scream therapy. In that therapy they try to touch this point. In Hindu tradition it was called Garbhadana Samskara. There is a Upanishad, Garbhadana Upanishad, speaks about completion of the first pain you experience, first powerlessness you experience when you are born. Means, see, till you are born, you don't need to breathe independently. You don't need to eat independently. Everything is ready-made, supplied to your body directly. You just float in that warm bed, that's all. But the moment you come out, you need to now start breathing. Now you need to digest the food on your own. It's not that your mom will digest and give you directly the energy. You need to digest. So the coming out, once you come out, that moment you feel a deep powerlessness. That is the first primal powerlessness, powerless moment. And especially in the modern day birthing, somebody picks you up, two fat ladies with white gown and beat you damal damal in the back. This is the reception. No, it's like you enter some guest's house, they lock the door and beat you. where you are beaten when you are born and held upside down. They ask you, please come in, and you put your feet. There was a rope you did not observe, and suddenly they pull the rope and you are hanging upside down. It's exactly the same. Understand? Now in our system, the end pregnancy program, we make sure that kids are received consciously with the chanting and with the incense. A little incense is incense smell is enough for the kid to start breathing by itself. You don't need to beat the kid and make the kid cry. Now we are proving it. We are doing it and proving it. We have hundreds of evidences, testimonials, where the kids just come out and start smiling. Kids come out and just try to sit in Chinmudra. We have photographs where the kids are born smiling. So now, we are going to complete with the very source of powerlessness before even you use the word. Understand what I am saying? So the possibility for one more seed growing, one more pattern growing is stopped. So please listen carefully. Because I went to the next subject does not mean you already completed. No. I've initiated you into completion. That does not mean you have completed. Now because I am going to the next initiation, that does not mean you should not be doing the earlier completion. A lot of completion need to be done. But now the process I am going to lead you into is like a burning the very sea, very ground. When the ground itself becomes infertile. See, if the ground is fertile, you may buy, roast this seed. Some other seed can fall there by mistake and it can sprout. Let's bake the ground. Like how they bake the brick. Burn the ground. Boil the ground. Then nothing can grow. You are free from patterns and possible patterns. So right from the moment, when you take birth, that was the moment you feel first powerlessness. Because you have to breathe on your own. You have to do many things on your own. We will do a unique process called Samskara Dahana Kriya. First thought in your life itself was danger. Feeling danger that this place, planet Earth, is dangerous. Burning that thought, that powerless moment. It will not be actually a thought, because you will not know the word in those at that time. But just the powerless moment. Burning the powerless moments before the language started in you. We will enter into a very unique process. Maybe for the first time, you are going to write your autobiography. Go back to the earliest memory of your life. Start penning down all the unpleasant incidents of your life. Understand, I am introducing this context first time now. Because I have added the process. The more and more and more I get time, more and more and more I sit and chisel. It's like once you make a deity and you have time, then what you do? You try to make more jewels to the deity. More precise, more to the point. Less time, more result. So I try my best never to waste your time or energy. And never let you do anything which is not required. You do only precise required thing and straight you get the result. If you give a job to lazy man, he will find the easiest way to do it. Same way, I am seeing to it, I see to it that the easiest way for the highest consciousness is made available to you all. Go back to the earliest memory of your life. Start penning down all the incidents of your life as if you are writing a story. But very important thing, relive the emotions which you can't verbalize during each incident. Understand? The powerless space which you can't verbalize during each incident. One important thing you need to know, anything you remember only based on suffering. Means anything which does not have suffering or pain or powerlessness, you don't remember. If you are remembering your marriage, you would have had powerlessness, incompletion during that marriage time. Something, somebody would have said the food is not okay. Somebody would have said the banana tree is not there properly outside. Somebody would have said, oh, you are getting married to this fellow, gone. We know him. Oh, you are going to do this, this girl, okay, okay. Anything you remember, please understand, anything you remember. So it's like a, you need a base on that, on which you can write. Like you need either paper or a blackboard or a wall. On something only you can write. You can't write on the wall. Same way, all your memories are engraved on the powerlessness. That is why you never remember joyful moments. Because during the joyful moments, you are powerful. It's a break of your time shaft. In your time shaft, all the blissful moments are break. You remember before and after, not the moments. Because it was a blissful, it was a break. You understand what I am saying? The time shaft runs in the powerlessness. And the powerlessness you experienced, which can't be verbalized, live that. Please understand. In every instant, this is the shift. This is the addition. See, in every incident, see earlier when I say relive, you sit and relive that you are being beaten or you are abused or you got into some powerless moment, some problem, you sit and relive. Now, the important component, context, your whole energy and attention should be the emotion which is beyond verbalization, the powerlessness you felt beyond verbalization, relive that, complete with that. How many of you are getting? See, whenever you relive, not just the words you created about that file, what happened and what you perceived as happened, you relive all that. Then go deep, and the powerlessness you felt at that moment, which is beyond verbalization, which was the space in which this whole thing happened. You understand? See, the powerlessness space only made the inner mamakara to happen, ahankara to happen. Am I right? This is the ground on which that seed has sprouted. So now, during each incident, relive that powerless moment. Try to catch that moment, that emotion, which can't be verbalized. You understand what I am saying? It's like a, how can you move the water? Because it won't stand in the hand. You use a vessel and lift the water. And the water is like a space you can't verbalize. While you relive, this reliving will become a space where the powerlessness which can't be verbalized will be taken out. Please understand that powerless space which can't be verbalized, I am not asking you to verbalize. I am asking you to taste it in your under your tongue. See, when you go back to that space and go through it, how your tongue feels, how your heart feels, how your nervous system feels, how your liver feels. Feel how that feels on your nervous system. All of you are getting it?
Swamiji, does it mean that the incidents after we started speaking, that should not be there? It should be earlier to that? Maybe
no. After you speaking also, you will carry that space as underground. Continuously.
Because subsequently we could verbalize the same.
No, even if you verbalize, there will be a space which can't be verbalized. That out of that base material only, the verbalization will happen. From cotton, thread. The cotton is the base material which can't be verbalized. Thread is the verbalization. Yes. Go ahead. You will feel that, how it feels in the body. Yes, please.
And you have to start with your root pattern incidents, or you have to go beyond that as well?
As early as possible. Because the powerlessness has not started when you started the root pattern. After powerlessness grows a considerable level only, root pattern starts.
And you have to follow the incidences after the root pattern?
No. You have to start from as early as possible. Bring it this moment you are standing in the mic. Okay. The whole autobiography. Please listen. The attention should be not on the verbalizations you created and filed in your archives, but undercurrent mood which can't be verbalized you went through at that time. Understand what I am saying? See, for example, if you are supposed to relive the worst accident in your life, marriage. No. You will not just relive the photo album you created. Now first he came, she came and stood there and put the Mangalsutra. Not that. There will be an undercurrent experience which is deeper than verbalization. The mood in which the whole thing happened. Relive that. Complete with that.
Swamiji, this space you're talking about, it will be constant flavor throughout, right? Yeah. Okay. Thanks.
Swamiji, I just want to share that when we were doing all the processes and looking into the mirror, I thought I had already cleared until the meditation started. And I saw myself as a baby inside the womb. And
even with all this, you cleared only the verbalization space. Go into the deeper than verbalization space.
So being in the womb, you still have the verbalization?
No. What you saw is the womb.
Yeah.
The verbalization of the womb experience.
No, because I have this intense pain in the heart.
Please listen. If you really experience the space, powerless space you had in the womb, you will not see as a vision.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
You will not see vision or verbalization. You will only go through it. It's like you will feel the suddenly your liver is digesting well. Suddenly you will see that things are looking more green. Green is looking greener. It will just be released through your system without verbalization. Getting it? And you can do that also. Or you can relive and then pen down also. Anything is okay. But you have to finish both.
Swamiji, I will go in that moment and I will feel that sensation, but how to complete that sensation?
Even if you feel and go through, that's enough. That's completion. It will be released through your system. It will go out. Okay. So now, with this process, you are all getting ready to have a complete Kundalini awakening. Because all the obstructions, all the blockage stops your Kundalini will be cleared. Till now, whatever Kundalini awakening you experience will be only one part of your Kundalini in one or two chakras. When this happens, all your chakras will be ready to receive the Kundalini in full form.